Aloha, this is Howard Dashefsky reporting from Pahoa on the Big Island. We are here at the intersection of Old Pahoa Road, and this is Highway 130. This is the highway that runs up to Leilani Estates, the subdivision which has been evacuated and remains empty for the most part since lava first broke out there late last week. Now, this is the first stop. You can see we have people from Big Island Police. We also have the Hawaii National Guard on hand. Folks here have to present identification, driver's licenses and such to prove that they do live beyond this point here. Now, once they go through this preliminary check, they're going to drive about 2 miles up the road, and that's where you actually get to Leilani Estates. We were there this morning. They were supposed to start letting people in at 7 o'clock, but they said no because the fumes coming from the volcano, too dangerous. But finally, by 8 o'clock, they gave the all clear, and we were there when the first person went in. Now, normally, media would not be allowed in, but they allowed us to follow this gentleman in because he requested our help. He was injured. He had his prized brand new riding lawnmower, and he needed help to lift things into his truck and get them out. I could tell you, once we went into the subdivision, it was eerie. Not only is it completely empty, there was nobody in there, and there are more than 700 homes, but there were large cracks in the road, 2, 3, 4 inches wide, and out of those cracks, the steam flowing unbelievably that we drove through, and looking down, you could almost see a little bit of an orange glow coming out of it. Any one of those cracks can turn into the next fissure and open up and become a lava flow right at that very spot. Fortunately, we were able to get in, help the gentleman grab his belongings, and then we were able to get back out. And when we were out, there were already hundreds of cars lined up that are likely going to be on this road, in this highway for hours, trying to get back to their homes that will hopefully still be standing. In the meantime, down here, the volunteer area continues. This is where people from the surrounding communities have been coming for the last couple days, dropping off supplies, food, water. A big pallet of pet food just arrived just now. They actually had cots in here. People were sleeping overnight. And there's also a whole lot of clothes that's been donated because, again, the people that had to flee at the end of the week were only there with the clothes that were on their back. But we're going to continue to monitor the situation. Obviously, this could go on for days, weeks, or even months. Nobody knows. But we'll continue to follow it. I'm Howard Dashefsky reporting again from Kalapana area in Pahoa on the Big Island. For now, we send it back to you.